Now, a U.S. soldier on active duty in Iraq has called President Obama an imposter, a pretender. As an active duty officer in the United States Army, he said, "I have grave concerns about the constitutional eligibility of Barack Hussein Obama to hold the office of President of the United States." According to the soldier's name is Scott Easterling, he said, "Obama has absolutely refused to provide to the American public his original birth certificate, as well as other documents which may prove or disprove his eligibility. In fact, he has fought every attempt made by concerned citizens in their effort to force him to do so." So this soldier says, look, this is a very dangerous thing. I've pledged to uphold the Constitution. The Constitution says that he has to be a natural-born citizen. He refuses to allow that to be confirmed. Why? Is this another confirmation that he is a master deceiver? Another U.S. soldier now on active duty in Iraq is joining the challenge. He said, "I was inspired by Easterling's story and am writing to inform that I would like to be added as a plaintiff against Obama as well, if you feel it would help." His letter was directed to California attorney Orly Tatz, who, along with her Defend Our Freedom USA Foundation, is working on a series of legal cases seeking to uncover Obama's birth certificates and other documents that would reveal whether he meets the requirements of the U.S. Constitution. This is not a political issue. This is a moral issue that undergirds the very existence of the republic. If you cannot trust that your leader, your chief leader, your commander-in-chief meets the standards of the document that you are sworn to uphold and that every citizen trusts to secure the blessings of liberty to ourselves and our posterity, there is nothing left. Such a leader can do anything they want. Easterling, who confirmed separately that he's questioning Obama's authority, wrote to Tatz that, "As an active duty officer in the United States Army, I have grave concerns about the constitutional eligibility of Barack Hussein Obama to hold the office of President of the United States." The second soldier said, "I'm an Army reservist who was activated last August and am currently serving with a military police battalion in Iraq. When I enlisted last year, I had to show," listen to this, "when I enlisted, I had to show my birth certificate, as well as my driver's license, high school diploma, college transcripts, social security card. I also filled out loads of paperwork to include listing the names, addresses, and phone numbers of my family members, and had to answer any questions regarding foreign travel." He said, "I think it's reasonable for Obama to prove his citizenship status, thus certifying his eligibility. I too raised my right hand and swore an oath to defend the Constitution of the United States. I believe the case you are filing could very well determine if we are in fact a constitutional republic or a nation of mob rule." He said, "I would be honored to be a part of your efforts." Now, a United States Senator, Richard Shelby in Alabama, is weighing in on this controversy, saying he's never seen any proof that the president was actually born in the United States. Then, a Democratic attorney, a man who has been a leader in the Democratic Party, he served as Deputy Attorney General in Pennsylvania and now is leading a number of lawsuits over the eligibility of President Barack Obama to occupy the Oval Office, has told radio talk show host that not only is Obama not eligible to be president, he's probably an illegal alien and should be deported. If it's true, what I'm alleging, that he is an illegal alien, Obama should be arrested and deported, said the attorney, Mr. Berg, in an interview. He's been a leader among attorneys across the nation, bringing dozens of claims against Obama over the status of his citizenship. He is convinced Obama was born in Kenya to a minor mother, a U.S. citizen, and a Kenyan father who was subject to British rule. The U.S. Constitution, meanwhile, demands that occupants of the White House qualify as a natural-born citizen. We must seek the truth, he said. We're going to continue until we expose this situation. He's a total fraud. He's a phony, said this attorney. This is the biggest fraud ever in the United States. Now, I can't verify that it is, but if indeed he is not a natural-born citizen, he well knows that. And then it is, indeed, the biggest fraud ever perpetrated on the people of the United States. This makes the Bernard Madoff Ponzi scheme pale into insignificance, relatively. Senator Jim DeMint, now a staunch opponent of the federal government's increase in size and spending legislation, this so-called stimulus package, is standing up and calling Americans to stand up and take their freedom back. He's saying, freedom is in the people's hands right now, and it's about to slip through. Friends, it all finds its roots in moral and spiritual compromise that ultimately has led to a reprobate mind, and now freedom itself is lying in the balance. This is Viewpoint. Viewpoint determines destiny. There are no neutral viewpoints. This has not been a political diatribe here today. It is a plaintive cry, particularly to professing Christians, to be and become the people that God is calling us to be and become. Jesus is coming soon. The scriptures foretell that chaos will reign in the earth, that there will be a one-world government supported by a one-world economy and a one-world religion. And all of the foundations for that have been put in place as we speak by deceit.